A very good morning to you children. Continuing with the chapter light, here we are in the third part of it, and in this we'll learn about the rectilinear propagation of light. Now, what is rectilinear propagation of light? Let us start with few examples. Have you ever noticed that when you are in a dark room and there is a crack or a hole in the window or the door, or sunlight from outside, it enters the dark room through the ventilator or the glass pane. Have you noticed how the light travels? Light always travels in straight line. When you are traveling at night and your father switches on the headlight of the car, then also you must have noticed that the beams of the light rays, they appear to travel in straight lines. Okay, then beams of light which comes from the projection room in the cinema hall, and this also suggests that light travels in straight lines. Now we'll talk about few examples. Okay, few activities. See, this is a rubber tube that I have taken and a burning candle placed at one end and a person is viewing from the other end. Okay, this tube is straight. Okay, then when the person is viewing from the other end, the person is able to view the flame of the candle. Now, I bend the tube and then I try to view the flame of the candle. Is it visible? No. Why? Because the flame, the light rays from the flame, it goes and hits the bend over here. Okay. So, from these we can say that light travels in straight lines. Then what is rectilinear propagation of light? It is the property of light traveling in straight lines. Okay, the property of light traveling in straight line, as long as it is traveling in the same medium, is called the rectilinear propagation of light. Now, let us understand this with the help of the activity that is given in your book, activity 1. In this, you see that there are three cardboards. Okay, and each of the cardboard has a hole in it. Okay. Now, what you do, you arrange the three cardboards in one behind the other in such a way that all the holes of the cardboard, they are in the same horizontal line. Okay, now you place a burning candle at one end and from the other side, you try viewing the flame of the candle. You will notice that the flame of the candle is visible. Now what you do, you displace one of these cardboards. Okay, either you displace C or B or A, any of the cardboards you displace. Then you try viewing from here. Is it visible? No. Why? Because the three holes, they are no longer in the straight line. This proves that light rays always travel in straight line. Okay. This property of rectilinear propagation of light, it has many applications in our day-to-day life. Shadows are formed because of the rectilinear propagation of light. We'll study about this in detail in this chapter. Now, days and night, the formation of the day and night, this also suggests that light travels in straight lines. If this were not so, if the light would not have been traveling in straight lines, it would be traveling in curved paths around the earth, then what would have happened? Then we would be having sunlight during nights also, isn't it? Yes, we would not be having dark nights, we would be having lighted nights, because light must be taking a curved path and reaching us. Since light travels in straight lines, that is why we do not have sunlight at night. Then eclipses. eclipses also occur because of the rectilinear propagation of light. Then pinhole camera, it also works on the principle of rectilinear propagation of light. Now when I am talking about pinhole camera, what is a pinhole camera? It is a simple device that is used to take photographs of stationary objects. And as I told you, that pinhole camera, it works on the principle that light travels in straight lines. Okay, we'll understand this with the help of this pinhole camera example. Now, to construct this pinhole camera, we have a rectangular cardboard box. This is a rectangular cardboard box. And this side, one side of the cardboard box is made of greased paper or it is ground glass screen. Okay. And the side opposite to it, it has a hole in the middle. And the size of the hole is equal to the pin head. Pin. This is a pin. Okay. It is the size of this pin head. Okay, and the box is blackened from inside so that it absorbs any light which falls on it, its walls. Okay, now how does this work? Okay, we have a burning candle AB in front of this pinhole camera. The rays starting from different points of the candle, they travel in straight lines. Okay, they all travel in straight lines. The ray which starts from A, it passes through this hole edge and it hits the screen at A dash. From B, it passes through edge and goes and hits the screen at B dash. Okay, so all the rays starting in between A and B, after they pass through the pinhole, they travel in straight lines, pass through the pinhole and they meet the screen between A dash and B dash. So, this A dash and B dash is what? It is the image of the object AB. AB is what? AB is the object. Okay. Object. And this is the image. Now, what kind of an image am I getting? See, the flame is at the top. Here, the flame is at the bottom. We get an inverted image of the candle. Okay. Now suppose this distance between the pinhole and the screen. This is the pinhole and this is the screen. This is reduced and this is I bring the screen to PQ. Okay, this screen is brought to PQ. Okay, what will you notice? That the size of the image has reduced. Okay, this is the flame and this is the candle. The size of the image reduces when the distance between the pinhole and the screen is reduced. Okay, now if the distance between the pinhole and the screen is increased, brought to P1, Q1, then the size of the image is much larger. Okay, but the image gets less bright when it spreads over a large area. We get a blurred image when it is spread over a large area. Okay, then what is the nature of the image that we are getting? The nature of the image is that it is real because the image is being formed on the screen. Okay, what are real images? Images formed on the screen are real images. So, the image is being formed on the screen, so it is a real image, but then it is inverted. Okay, understood? It is inverted image. And it is generally smaller than the size of the object. Okay, the size of the image, it also depends upon the distance between the pinhole and the object. Okay, the size of image, it also depends upon the pinhole and the distance, the distance between the pinhole and the object. Okay, I think it's clear. Pinhole camera is clear to you. In the next video, we'll be studying about shadows.